What you should have seen is the fish swimming back and forth between the left and the right side with some typical duration, although it's a random process. And that random process typically stays on one side for a number of time steps that depends on the probability of staying for one time step. So here, if that probability is 0.9, then after about 10 time steps, the fish will have left their initial point and gone back to some random equilibrium distribution. If the probability of staying was 0.95 per time step, then it takes about 20 time steps before the fish randomize. And if it's 0.98, then it takes about 50 time steps to randomize. And the general rule here is that if your probability of staying is P, then the time scale on which you stay on one side is of the order 1 over 1 minus P. That's a good order of magnitude estimate for this process. So next, we're going to understand how we can assess where the fish are. That's using our measurements. What are our measurements? We're catching fish. And that also are those also are the rewards that we get. So we'll have two different probabilities. One of catching fish if you're on the same side as the fish, and another if you're on the other side from the fish. And of course, you'll catch more fish when you're on the side with the school. And you'll only catch stragglers on the other side. So it's your turn to catch some fish. So here you can say and enforce the fish to stay on one side by picking P stay equals 1. And then you have two reward probabilities, P high and P low. And you'll catch fish on one of those sides or the other, depending on your initial condition. So here you'll set the initial condition to be left for both the fish and for you. And you'll just stay on that side. And the fish will stay on that side because P stay equals 1. And see what the when you catch the fish. Then you can switch so the fish start on the other side, and you can compare how often you catch fish in those cases. All right, your turn.